Chariots of Fire, a pretty inspirational movie. Are you looking forward to it tonight?
Absolutely. I've seen it many, many moons ago. As an ex-athlete myself, it's something that I can relate to. Spent many years, years training and hoping to be the best in the world. So yeah, good film. Looking forward to see it remade.
We were chatting to Nigel a little bit earlier on. He said he went through the training regime. From seeing it from an athlete's point of view, do they do it justice?
Do you know what? Yes, they do. I wasn't around back then. The equipment was slightly different, but from what I remember of the film, because it's been a few years since I've seen it, yes, they do pretty justice. And there's always that worry about not doing a film justice when you're, acting over an athlete or a policeman or whatever the case may be. But yeah, I think they do a good job.
And when you are training, doing a bit of Keep Fit in the Gym, I suppose, is the soundtrack on the playlist?
Do you know what? I never used to listen to music when I was training. I was there to work, not to have fun. And it just got in the way. So no, I never listened to any music. But having said that, it is the sort of thing that I would listen to leading up to a race or something like that.
What's going to be going through our athletes' heads then this summer? They're there on the start line or just about to take part in their competition. What goes through the mind?
First thing, hope to God it don't rain. And to be honest, all seriously, they would have done all the work, would have done all the training, and it's just down to business. It's just about performing when it matters and going through the motions. I used to always, visualise my races weeks, months, sometimes even years before it happened, and you just go through those things over and over and over again in your mind. Everything else is blocked out, tunnel vision, and for me, as soon as the gun goes, you get on with the job in hand.
Just over 2 weeks to go until it all gets underway here in London. Where will preparation be now? Will they have kind of got to where they want to be and now it's just winding down and ticking over? Or
pretty much. The most number one thing is don't pick up an injury. Don't get any kind of injury. The odd athlete may have one more competition between now and then. There is a couple of weeks to go. Although there's 2 weeks to go before the start of the Games, there's the best part of 3 weeks before the athletic starts. So there's still enough time for athletes to get one or maybe two more races in. So they will be just fine-tuning. Training will be tapering down, they'll be just maintaining, and most of the athletes should be sort of knocking on the doors of their personal bests about now, so hoping that they set new personal bests come 3 weeks' time.
There is a lot of pressure from the media here in the UK. For Team GB, who do you reckon is going to give a standout performance this year?
I will say one thing is the pressure isn't going to be any greater than that you put on yourself. Most athletes, and I certainly was put the most pressure on myself than anybody else did. Stand out for athletes, you've got to look at the obvious Mo Farah, Philip Sadowu, Jessica Innes. But my outside bet for a gold is Robbie Grabatz in a high jump. I really think that kid could do it. And I don't want to put pressure on the guy, not even met him, but the guy is jumping out of his skin. And I reckon he's up for a medal and I think he could even possibly get a gold.
It must be a great honour to be selected to represent Team GB. There's been lots of that in the paper. David Beckham's non-inclusion. Have you got an opinion on that?
It's tough. Unfortunately, as an Olympian, as an athlete that's competed for my country, there's been championships where I have been picked for and there's ones that I haven't been picked for. The sad thing for David, he'll be around, but he may not be eligible 4 years' time because he'd possibly be at the twilight of his career. So it's a real tough one. And I know he wanted it badly to go, but I know he's going to be involved in some way. But unfortunately for all of us, we've had championships and competitions where we've wanted to be selected and haven't been selected. And, it's just one of those things that comes with the territory, unfortunately. I feel for him.
And finally, since the day we won the Olympics, it's been about the legacy after inspiring another generation. Do you think that this 2012 Olympics is going to have a lasting legacy?
I hope to God it will. I've been going around this year. I've visited more schools this year than I have in my life. In fact, I've been at school more time this year than I have when I was supposed to be at school. So I'm hoping that carry on. If it continues the way it is, then yes, it will. And that is an important thing. 2012 is important, but we've got 2016, 2020, 2024. These are Olympics that carry on, and we want Team GB, wherever those Olympics are held, to come back and with a bag full of medals. So I hope it does.